Hello students. So today in this module we are going to read the poem A Photograph by Shirley Tolson. Before this we read the chapter The Portrait of a Lady. I hope you all are covering your syllabus, learning all the chapters, doing the assignments and making notes that we are updating time and again. Now coming to this topic, A Photograph by Shirley Tolson. Here is a picture of the poet, and let me tell you children what this poem is about exactly. The poet is nostalgic here. She is missing her mother, who is no more, and it's human tendency when we miss someone, we see their photographs. So the poet is looking at her mother's photograph that was clicked when her mother was merely 12 years old and went on a sea holiday with her cousins. The three stanzas of the poem depict three different stages of life, which are adolescence, adulthood, death. And you'll get to know how this photograph is related to the memory of the poet. Now the first stanza, children, it says, "The cardboard shows me how it was when the two girl cousins went paddling, each one holding one of my mother's hands." Let's check the glossary, children. I find here paddling word difficult. So the meaning of paddling is walking through water. Literary device which is used in this stanza, that is allusion. An allusion is a reference or an incident mention of something either directly or by implication. So here the cardboard, it refers to the photograph actually. Now come to the explanation part, students. In these lines, the poet is looking at an old photo album which is made up of cardboard. The poet looks at a picture of her mother and gets to know how her mother went on a sea holiday with the two cousin sisters and was walking through water at the beach holding each other's hands. Now this is the literal meaning of the stanza which is written here. Let's check the analysis, children. The photograph pasted onto a piece of cardboard suggests the idea of fragility and uncertainty of human life. It is vulnerable to change as the people in picture have proven to be. In the photo, the mother of the poet, the big girl, then a 12-year-old girl, serves as a source of security and reassurance to her younger cousins, each one holding hand. This refers to that, children. Ironically, the mother herself is now dead, signifying inevitability of death and mortality of humans. Now the next stanza says, "And she, the big girl, some 12 years or so, all three stood still to smile through their hair at the uncle with the camera, a sweet face, my mother's. That was before I was born." The literary device used in the stanza is alliteration, which is used in the phrase "stood still to smile," and you can see here, children, that the sound of S is being repeated here. That is why alliteration is there. Let's check the explanation of this stanza. The poet in the stanza tells us that she, the mother, was a big girl and the other girls were younger to her. The three girls, mother in the center and the other two on both the sides of mother standing and holding her hand, are standing still looking at the uncle who was clicking the picture. They all were smiling through their hair as their hair was falling on their faces due to wind at the seaside. The poet refers her mother's face as a sweet face and also mentions that this picture belongs to the time before the poet's birth, which is obvious because the mother was 12 years old then. The next stanza says, "And the sea, which appears to have changed less, washed their terribly transient feet some 20-30 years later." Let's check glossary here. Transient means lasting only for a short time, something which is temporary. Literary devices which are used in the stanza, the first one is transferred epithet, which is used in the line "transient feet." The second one is alliteration, where repetition of P is there, children, terribly transient or 20-30. Come to the explanation. The poet says that the sea which washed the feet of the three girls in the photograph, it has changed less. The poet's mother and her cousins, Betty and Dolly, they are no more. But see, it has not changed much. Now come to the analysis part. The poet is setting contrast here in this stanza between the lifespan of human beings and nature. By coining the phrases like terribly transient feet for her mother and the cousins of her mother, the poet is actually showing us that how brief a lifespan is in compared to nature. As at present, when the poet is an adult and looking at the snapshot, her mother is no more, while the sea where the picture was clicked appears the same and has changed very less after so many years. It is actually highlighting the brevity of our lifespan, whereas nature is perennial. Coming to the next stanza, she would laugh at the snapshot. "See Betty and Dolly," she would say, "and look how they dressed us for the beach. The sea holiday was her past. Mine is her laughter. Both try with the labored ease of loss." Literally revised, children, here, oxymoron in labored ease of loss, because two antonyms or two opposite words are put together. Labored is referring to difficulty, something which is difficult, and ease is easy. So both are the opposites and coming together. So that's why there is oxymoron figure of speech. Now come to the explanation, children. Now the poet recollects how her mother laughed at the snapshot and felt disappointed at the loss of her childhood joys. The sea holiday was her mother's past at the time, while her mother's laughter is the poet's past now. The poet highlights again how they both, the mother and the poet, though at different periods of time, reconcile with their respective losses and the pain involved in recollecting the past with great difficulty. Analysis, children. Now the tone of the poem, it changes into lamentation from nostalgic. Like earlier I told you that the poet is nostalgic, she is missing her mother. Nostalgia is when you are looking into your past. Okay. So here what happens, the tone of the poem is changing here, and it seems as if poet is more of lamenting or grieving the loss of her mother, and she laments, you know, and she says that the sea holiday was the past of her mother, while the mother's laughter seeing that photograph, it is a moment of past for the mother, as her mother is no more or she is dead. Now the next stanza says, now she has been dead nearly as many years as that girl lived, and of this circumstance, there is nothing to say at all. Its silence silences. The literary device used in the stanza is alliteration again, silence silences. The poet reveals that it's almost 12 years since her mother died. And for this circumstance, which refers to mother's death. So is it clear that this circumstance refers to the death of the poet's mother? So now for this circumstance, the poet has nothing to say. For poet is filled with gloom and an acute sense of loss. And this painful silence of the situation leaves her with no words to express her grief. Thus the silence silences her also. Analysis, children, here. The three stanzas, like I told you, the three stanzas, the first one, the second and the third, three stanzas are depicting the three different stages of life. As I told you earlier, that first stanza refers to adolescence or girlhood of mother. The second stanza refers to adulthood of mother and girlhood of a childhood of the poet. And the third stanza, the last stanza, refers to the death of mother while the poet is an adult now. So children, now you must have understood what this poem, A Photograph, contains, what it actually depicts. Now let's come to the point of justification of title. A photograph is an apt title as it provides the palpable representation of a past that the poet cannot control. Her mother, a girl of 12 years, is captured in this photograph paddling into the sea with her younger cousin sisters. Whenever the mother looks at the photograph with her daughter, it always makes her happy. Remembrance of her past, a happy childhood, and even in the silly way her parents dressed them for the beach. Now, when the poet has grown up, she no longer can hear her mother's laughter. Unfortunately, her mother has died over a decade ago. However, by looking at this photograph, she can both remember her mother's past and, more importantly, recollect her laughter. In her loss, silence silences, but the photograph now brings happy memories to the poet, just as it did for her mother, by providing a window to a more joyful time. Children, theme of the poem. Now, the poet here talks about the power of memories captured in still photographs, which can evoke smiles and tears both at the same time. We all keep looking into our past and want to relive those days gone by. But the temporary happiness pinches even more as the void is only widened. But it somehow fuels us to go for future. The poet also highlights the brevity of human lifespan in compared to nature. And children, the sub-theme of the poem that whispers the inevitability of death in the ears of the readers, which is the most bitter truth of our life. Now, children, let's assess how much you understood it. Okay, so here is the assignment for assessment, for self-assessment, so that you get to know how much you understood in the poem or where are you actually lagging. Besides these questions, there are some other assignments and notes also related to the poem, which are uploaded on ERP. So you can download the assignments and all from there. The assignments are to be done on loose sheets and your notes to be written in the notebook. In case of any problem, any doubts there, you can send it to me and I'll be addressing your doubts in either in the live lectures or perhaps in the next module. Thank you. Take care of yourself. Stay safe.